eggs were Horlies.
Hey guys, Rob from Georgia here with you. I'm your Wednesday evening host at Body Bags, and this is week 305, and this week I bring you Claudio Lattanzi Zombie 5, aka Killing Birds. And this is a movie that I have never had in my collection until yesterday. Compliments of my daughter and a belated Father's Day gift. And this is the Shriek Show DVD. And you can find this on Amazon for about $15. And or Amazon UK, there's some various editions there going on. But this is the Shriek Show DVD. And this completes the set. I now have the entirety of the zombie set, which is pretty awesome. But Zombie 5, our cast real quick. Laurie Wendell as Anne, Robert Vaughn as the Dr. Fred Brown, of course Timothy Watts as Steve, and Leslie Cumming as Mary, and there's a few others there that help drive our plot narrative, which really is, we start the film off with sort of a flashback, I guess, sort of a setup scene. We have a soldier from Vietnam who does a tour, and he's come home early, perhaps, and his wife apparently is not expecting this arrival, and he will catch her and her lover, and he will he'll deal with them and in a pretty brutal fashion, and the in-laws will show up as well, and he will deal with them, and they have brought the baby with them. Apparently they've been babysitting, and he'll take possession of the baby momentarily, but not before he's actually attacked by some of the birds. Now, when you first enter this house, of course, there's, you know, they got bird cages everywhere, and so, you know, the idea of birds in general is that theme is thick, right? And almost in a gentle type way. It's really kind of weird, but he'll deal with them, but in the process, as I've said, he'll be attacked, and he'll lose an eye, he'll get blinded in the other eye, and so he is not, as a character, he is not marred by his actions, and I guess the birds sort of take it upon themselves to deliver a little bit of vengeance, right? And so he'll take the baby, and the baby will be handed over to the appropriate authorities, and he'll do some time, and then at some point, he will get out, and he will, I guess, go into the field of researching birds, and he'll sort of live in a seclusion, and this is, of course, shot in Louisiana, takes place in Louisiana, so out near the swamps, he'll sort of live in seclusion and do his research, right? Well, you know, we get into present day, and we got a group of college students who, one in particular, Steve, has got a college grant to study a type A woodpecker that is believed to be out there in the swamp somewhere. Of course, not too far from where Dr. Brown lives, right? And he is, of course, our chief guy that we're introduced to at the very beginning, who is now trying to live out the rest of his life. Well, they'll go search him out because they believe he has the necessary information on this particular woodpecker. And when they do find him and speak to him, they don't really get what they're looking for, so to speak, so they decide to go out into the swamps and look for themselves. And in the process, they will stumble upon the house that we're first introduced to at the beginning of the film. Of course, it's been vacated, and because daylight is quickly coming to an end, the command decision is made that they'll stay in this house overnight, where, you know, over the course of the night, a lot of bad things are going to happen, and really, that is your film. Now, there are some other things going on, and of course, you have a setup for a reason. And the baby who's been in foster care, well, the baby is one of these kids who is out there. And so these things will come to light as the narrative drives forward. And it's interesting. It's not quite the movie that I thought I was going to see. Quickly onward, there is really a ghost house vibe, even maybe not a far stretch to invoke House by the Cemetery, and much, much more than zombie. And I think a lot of this has to do with Claudio's work with both Lindsay and Sauvé, while he was second unit director, but also the work of Cardillo, the composer. Also, though, Joe D'Amato effect as producer and the guy behind Filmraj, you know, there's that connection. And so it does have a, it does feel like maybe it should have been more placed in the La Casa marketing strategy and not Zombie, but it's Zombie. And so it ought to be in your set if you're a purist in the sense of, you know, the set. I'm not a purist in the sense of all the 88s, all the arrows and whatnot, but I have longed for this set. I've always wanted this set. And I think a lot of it had to do with the cover art. You know, it's some cool stuff going on here. But so, you know, some of my thoughts. I enjoyed this film. Of course, I just love Italian cinema anyways. And that's not to say that it's perfect cinema. It's just, for whatever reason, I personally tap into what it has to offer in some interesting ways. I get a kick out of it. And this particular film, as I said, it really does invoke some, I don't know, some ghost house. And there is a discussion on how much Lattanzi directed this film. There's some would say that Joe D'Amato actually directed the film or directed much of it or at least chunks of it. Really, no one knows for sure. And there is a scene towards the end, though, that is right out of the pages of Joe D'Amato's Anthropophagus, which begs, did he do that scene, if not that scene, along with some other scenes? And again, I did say Filmraj. This is a Filmraj film. And of course, I've said this in reviews before, that going back to the days as a kid and renting the VHS tape of Stage Fright, that first time that Filmraj come up, man, I was hooked. I can't explain to you what it is exactly, but just seeing, and there goes my DVD case. I don't know. So I was surprised that when I kicked this in this morning, the first thing I see as the movie's about to begin is Filmraj. And I'm like, I didn't realize this was a Filmraj product. And man, I was in right then. And but that's just me. And and the movie, I mean, it's an hour and it's about an hour and a half, and it can feel like it tends to drag at points, but for me, I mean, I'm picking up all these weird little things, so I never really felt that. But I can see how somebody else might. And but the story, they don't overdo themselves, but they do try to offer some intriguing things along the way that remain pretty surface level. You know, this is not brain surgery here. But through the context of how the film is shot and what they offer, it does have some interesting scenes. Like I said, if you're a big fan of Fulci, if you're a fan of Lenzi and, of course, you know, Sauvé and these other guys, it does bring some intriguing scenes that do at least carry a vibe, if not a little bit more. And so, you know, it's fun. And the end, well, the end as things are wrapped up and sort of things are put in their proper place, we do have, although we're not really privy, we do have a climactic moment involving birds in sort of an Argento style. Maybe I'm thinking opera, but you'd have to see the film to see where I'm really going with that. Yeah, look, I mean, you know, I mean, as far as the technicalities of the film, the only thing that really jumped out at me, and I'm still a novice at this stuff, it just seemed like the humidity factor in Louisiana played some tricks with the lenses. You know, in a lot of exterior shots, the lenses, it just seems like they're fogging up, where in the interior shots, everything is pretty clear. And, you know, one of the characters does say something to the effect of, boy, it's foggy out here. But I remember Carpenter saying that they had a lot of trouble with their lenses, the cameras, when they were shooting The Thing, you know, being inside all night and coming out in the, you know, in the morning. That humidity or the moisture factor, you know, played havoc with those lenses. And I think that's what we have here. More of that kind of thing. But yeah, I mean, Zombie 5, I mean, you know, it's got some nice sequences. The gore factor is not near as much as you would think it would be for a film like this. You sort of get off a little easy in terms of that. But there are some sequences that do happen that, you know, pretty cool. That Anthropophagus lift towards the end is pretty, it's not quite as good as it is in Anthropophagus, but it was, I was sort of like, dang, is this happening? And there's a scene that involves a generator and a guy's necklace getting tangled in. That's pretty cool. There's a great scene, I think, where one of our girls in the beginning, zombie sort of comes out of the shadows, and there's that sort of Fulci effect where the hand kind of rawr, grabs the head and starts doing a boom, boom, boom against the wall sort of effect. So there's a little bit of nastiness going on in this film, but nothing really like the original zombie, of course. But anyway, so there you have it. Zombie 5. If you've never seen it, you need to check it out. I mean, you've seen the other zombie movies. You need to check this one out. But don't expect you're going to get a lot of continuity in terms of, well, you don't get a lot anyways in the zombie films. I mean, you know, there's one classic, and that is Fulci's 79 masterpiece of a film, right? But I am glad that I have it, not just because it completes a set, but the film itself. I get into Ghost House, I get into, you know, a lot of Fulci. And so, this was cool to watch. And Robert Vaughn is cool to watch as well. And so I got a kick out of it. And I really enjoyed it a lot. So you need to check it out. Claudio Lattenzi does get credit, so we'll just give it to him. Zombie 5, and at least technically speaking as a marketing strategy, it caps off the zombie franchise, if you will. So I hope I've said something interesting, and I hope I've motivated you to check this out if you haven't. So again, this is Rob from Georgia, and just keep plugging into body bags, and a lot of work goes into this stuff. And these guys, everyone's doing a fantastic job here. And so do check us out every day, because there's a new video up every day. So as always, we end these things off with Go Bills.